75 years ago today that a young boy went to sea for the first time on a ship sailing to Normandy. His name was Jim Radford, and at 15 years of age, he is believed to be the youngest person to see active service in the D-Day landings. Some years later, he wrote a song remembering that eventful day. Last week, a recording of that song, entitled Shores of Normandy, was released as a charity single, and the money raised helped to pay for the memorial that was unveiled at our march this morning. The record has reached number one in the pop music charts. I am proud to sing it for you on this special day. I would point out that if you buy the record, it's Jim Radford singing, not me. Shores of Normandy. In the cold grey light on the 6th of June, in the year of 44, the Empire Lodge sailed out from Poole to join with thousands more. The largest fleet the world has seen, we sailed in close array, and we set our course for Normandy on the dawning of the day. Now the Empire Lodge was a deep sea tug with a crew of 33, and I was just a galley boy on my first trip to sea. I little thought when I left home of the dreadful sights I'd see, but I came to manhood on the day that I first saw Normandy. There was not one man in all our crew that knew what lay in store, though we had waited for this day through 5 long years of war. We knew that many would not see turn, but all our hearts were true, for we were bound for Normandy, where we had a job to do. At Armanche, off the beach of gold, neath the rocket's deadly glare, we towed our block ships into place, and we built a harbour there. Mid shot and shell, we built it well, as history does agree, while brave men died in the swirling tide on the shores of Normandy. For every hero's name that's known, 1,000 died as well. On stakes and wires their bodies hung, rocked in the ocean swell. And many a mother wept that day for the sons they loved so well. Men who cracked a joke or catched a smoke as they stormed the gates of hell. As the years go by, I can still recall the men I saw that day, who died upon that blood-soaked sand where now sweet children play. And those of you who were unborn, who've lived in liberty, remember those who made it so on the shores of Normandy. Remember those who made it so on the shores of Normandy. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Johnson, one of our fellow guests, thank you so much.